Hello everyone, welcome back. Today's video is on two simple and healthy oats breakfast recipes and my current spice bottle arrangement. Moving to my first oats recipe, into a bowl add half a cup of oats. My measurement is approximately for one person. You may increase the quantity as per your requirement. Into it add the same quantity, that is half a cup of milk. Here I am adding one banana. You may add any fruit as per your preference. For sweetness, add 2 tablespoons of honey or sugar. I am also adding around half a teaspoon of cocoa powder. This is just for flavor, it's optional. You may also add Horlicks, Milo or any other flavoring milk powders. Office goers can prepare this the previous night, refrigerate it in the lunchbox itself. The next morning can easily be taken as your breakfast. Moving on to the second oats recipe. Into a bowl add half a cup of oats. Here I am using a quarter cup for measurement. Into it goes half a cup of curd. This curd is not at all sour. For a smooth consistency, I am going to blend it before adding it into the oats. For sweetness, add 2 tablespoons of honey. If you are not soaking it overnight, let it sit for 5-10 minutes or until the oats absorb some water and turns mushy. You may add any fruit of your choice. Here I am adding one banana. After resting for around 5-10 minutes, the consistency of chocolate oats seems to be perfect, but the other one is slightly thick. If you are at your office, I would suggest you to take your water bottle and add a little bit of water to make the consistency as per your preference. For some crunchiness, nuts may be taken in a separate container and added to the porridge just before having it. This is a simple, easy and filling breakfast or dinner which can easily be prepared. Moving on to my current spice bottle arrangement. I had been collecting these honey bottles for quite some time now. I want to use this as my spice containers, as it perfectly fits my kitchen drawers. So let's start by removing the stickers first. I have been following this method to remove stickers for some time now, and it has proven to be quite effective. Here I am heating the water. We don't need boiling water. Now bubbles have started coming, so I am switching the flame off and pouring this water into the bottles. Make sure that the water is filled above the label marking. Now close the bottles with the lid and keep it aside for 5 to 10 minutes. Let's see whether the labels are coming off. If you feel that it is not coming off, keep it for another 5 minutes. In my case, the labels are coming pretty easily. Similarly, removing the label from the other side as well. This is my second bottle. The labels could easily be removed in this case also. As you can see, this is a bit of a stubborn sticker, so one has to remove it slowly. If it is removed abruptly, paper will be torn off and half of the paper will stick to the container itself. The sticker residue can be removed with a normal scrub. For some stickers, metal scrub might be required. I had to use metal scrub to remove the residue completely. Once the residue is removed, wash it well and let it dry. This is a chalkboard marker which I have purchased locally. Here I am initially writing with pencil. The writing may not be visible in the camera but can easily be erased by hand. Once I am satisfied with the writing and alignment, I will overwrite it with a permanent white marker. Chalkboard stickers are available in different shapes and sizes in most department stores. It can also be bought as a roll and cut it into any desired shape as per our liking. Now I am going to stick this onto the container. Now filling the content from old container to the new container. Keeping a spoon inside for easy usage. I have finished around half of my spice jars. I plan to do a bit more. This is how it looks in my cupboard. Hope you like this video. See you soon with another video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.